Magna Petra, a US space startup, focuses on extracting helium-3 from the moon. They claim to be the first lunar resources company prospecting and extracting helium-3 isotopes. But this is not correct. Interlune, a company I have covered on this channel already, is also prospecting for helium-3, and they were founded in 2020. Interlune emerged from stealth in 2024, around the time or a little earlier than the announcements from Magna Petra about their partnerships. More about that later in the video. We now have two companies racing to prospect, extract, and return helium-3 isotopes to Earth for commercial sale. Both are based in the US and both came out of stealth mode fairly recently. For more on Interlune, check out my dedicated video on them. Magna Petra, which is Latin for great rock or important rock, is unlocking lunar resources for benefit on Earth. Their primary focus is helium-3, which has a market price of around $30,000 to $50,000 per gram, or $30 to $50 million per kilo. All global resources on Earth would total about 60 kilos of helium-3, making it exceptionally scarce. Mining helium-3 on the moon is really hard. Its concentration in lunar regolith is only a few parts per billion, requiring up to 150 tons of lunar soil to be processed for a single gram of helium-3. However, permanently shadowed regions of the moon may offer higher yields, potentially reaching 50 parts per billion. Many associate helium-3 solely with nuclear fusion, where it could serve as an ideal fuel for reactors that don't yet exist commercially. However, helium-3 also has other practical applications, which I'll explore later in this video. Magna Petra states that there is a worsening and unresolved supply crisis for helium-3. Well, it's true that helium-3 is extremely rare on Earth, sourced mainly from the decay of tritium from decommissioned nuclear warheads. Global production is roughly 8 kilos per year, and a severe supply crunch in 2010 saw US reserves drop by 90%. Since then, mitigation efforts like recycling and adopting alternatives, such as boron-10 for neutron detection, have stabilized the situation somewhat. Still, supply consistently falls short of demand, creating a chronic shortage. With no new sources of helium-3 available on Earth, lunar mining seems like a viable means of sourcing helium-3 for use on Earth. The high price makes this business goal viable, with future use of helium-3 likely to increase over time. No company has managed to demonstrate lunar mining at scale yet. It's not clear that the cost of mining would be less than the value of helium-3 extracted. Before we get into the tech side of this strategy, let's first understand what helium-3 is and why the moon is a good place to prospect for it. Helium-3 is a rare, lighter isotope of helium containing two protons and only one neutron. Most helium-3 found in our solar system is a byproduct of the sun's internal processes and is dispersed into space on solar wind particles. While regular helium-4 makes up about 25% of all matter in the universe, and is easily found in natural gas deposits, helium-3 is incredibly scarce on Earth. Why the moon is a good place to look for helium-3? The solar wind, that is the stream of particles and plasma expelled from the sun, consists of ionized hydrogen, helium isotopes, and trace amounts of heavy elements, such as oxygen and even iron. The moon, which lacks a magnetic field, is bombarded by the solar wind, resulting in a buildup of helium isotopes on the surface. The Earth, by contrast, due to its powerful magnetic field, deflects the solar wind away from the planet, which is why no helium-3 is found naturally on the Earth, or in extremely low amounts, making it uneconomical to extract. Nearly all the helium we use on Earth is helium-4. That is a type of helium you find in party balloons, for example. Helium-3 accounts for 0.0001% of the helium on Earth. There are no good ways to extract or create helium-3 on the Earth. It's estimated there is over 1 million tons of helium-3 on the lunar surface. However, reports from recent lunar lander missions by China suggest that number could be conservative. The only way to know for sure is to land on the moon and survey the surface. That's exactly what Magna Petra plans to do. Magna Petra has developed, with the help of Stanford University, a simulation of over 4 billion years of solar winds, giving the company an understanding of the distribution and density of helium-3 on the lunar surface. The company is designing and building equipment for isotope extraction and containment, using proven systems from space equipment suppliers when possible. The company will leverage existing systems from the expanding cislunar ecosystem, such as lunar landers, rovers, power systems, and other needed technologies. It's worth noting that lunar mining does not need heavy equipment. It's not really mining, as the resources are on the lunar surface. It's more a matter of collecting, sieving, extracting, and processing the lunar dirt and dust. Magna Petra will only disturb the first few centimeters of the lunar surface. That's the top inch of lunar soil. This topsoil will have the highest concentration of isotopes deposited there by the solar winds. Adding a rover to the lunar collection device makes it look more like a tractor tilling the landscape. Outgas volatiles from the lunar soil will be captured and stored in a pressurized containment vessel. Once the tank is full, a process will be initiated to separate and expel heavier collected gases, trapping the lighter volatiles, including helium-3. The tanks will be transferred to a robotic rover and delivered back to the lunar lander for return to Earth. It's not clear whether only helium-3 will be collected on the moon, or whether the lighter collected volatiles will be returned to Earth for final separation and collection. It's likely that heavier gases such as nitrogen and carbon dioxide will be removed on the lunar surface, leaving helium-3, helium-4, and trace amounts of hydrogen. Removing helium-4 on the moon's surface is technically complex and energy intensive, so most likely this mix of helium will be returned and separated on Earth. Helium-3 has several uses here on Earth. Let's quickly go over them now. Helium-3 makes a good fuel for a nuclear fusion reactor. The reason is the fusion of helium-3 atoms doesn't cause radioactive waste products. With no neutron particles emitted, there's no neutron damage to reactor components, allowing for simpler, more compact designs without the need for heavy shielding. No commercial fusion reactors exist at the moment and may not exist for many years or even decades. Helium-3 for healthcare. Helium-3 is useful in several medical applications, including imaging and diagnostics. Helium-3 can be used for MRIs. Because helium is a non-reactive gas, it can be inhaled by patients to produce high-quality MRI images of the lungs. In addition, helium-3 can be used in neutron detectors for radiation therapy, ensuring the precise dose is delivered in cancer treatments. Helium-3 plays a crucial role in neutron detectors, used at borders to check for nuclear and radioactive materials. Helium-3 detectors have the highest sensitivity for detection of low-energy neutrons emitted by nuclear materials. Quantum computers need to be kept at extremely low temperatures to operate. Helium-3, when mixed with helium-4, creates a unique refrigerant capable of achieving temperatures close to absolute zero, a requirement for maintaining quantum coherence in many qubit designs. Lunar Pro AI. Magna Petra has built AI software to identify and assess mineral deposits on the moon's surface. The AI can identify isotope-rich areas with a high degree of accuracy. The company has built visual tools to display isotope deposits, along with estimated densities, depths, and energy requirements. This enables miners and project managers to plan extraction operations. Magna Petra teams up with ispace. In December 2024, Magna Petra joined forces with ispace, a Japanese space startup developing lunar landers, to advance lunar resource extraction. The partnership focuses on harvesting helium-3 from the moon. ispace, which has a lunar lander on its way to the moon for a June 2025 landing, plans additional missions in 2026 and 2027. Magna Petra will use ispace's lunar transportation expertise to support its helium-3 prospecting and collection efforts. Jeffrey Max, Magna Petra's CEO, said, "This collaboration is an important step in establishing a sustainable lunar resource economy. ispace's expertise and innovation make them an ideal partner for our mission objectives," unquote. Takashi Hakamada, founder and CEO of ispace, said this about the agreement. "We are pleased to cooperate with Magna Petra to transport their technology to the moon. The cislunar economy will be dependent on many important resources other than water, and it's important to work to make use of these resources," unquote. With upcoming reconnaissance and collection missions, Magna Petra is moving quickly to validate, capture, and return commercial quantities of helium-3 isotopes from the lunar surface. NASA Moon Observing Instrument to get another shot at lunar operations. A NASA-developed technology that recently proved its capabilities in the harsh environment of space will soon head back to the moon to search for gases trapped under the lunar surface thanks to a new agreement between NASA and Magna Petra. The mass spectrometer observing lunar operations, or MSOLO for short, successfully demonstrated the full range of its hardware in lunar conditions during the Intuitive Machines 2 mission earlier this year. With this new agreement, a second MSOLO, mounted on a commercial rover, will launch to the moon no earlier than 2026. Once on the lunar surface, it will measure trapped gases in the lunar soil in hopes of detecting lightweight isotopes, such as helium-3, which is theorized to exist in the topsoil of the lunar surface. The MSOLO instrument will be integrated on a commercial rover selected by Magna Petra. The rover will allow MSOLO to gather the data needed for researchers to understand which low molecular weight gases reside within the moon's surface. Under the agreement, signed on the 2nd of April 2025, Magna Petra will reimburse NASA for costs, such as supporting MSOLO integration and testing with a rover, pre-mission preparation and mission operations of the instruments, and expertise in system engineering, avionics, and software. Throughout the mission, NASA will retain ownership of MSOLO. Upcoming missions. Magna Petra plans two types of lunar missions, reconnaissance and return. Their reconnaissance missions will deploy NASA-provided scientific instruments, such as the MSOLO, on ispace's upcoming lunar landers to detect helium-3 and other volatiles. For collection and return missions, Magna Petra will conduct both robotic and crewed operations. The first robotic mission could launch as early as 2027, partnering with ispace or other partners. Given their use of NASA's MSOLO instrument, Magna Petra is well positioned to compete for future NASA Commercial Lunar Payload Services awards, boosting their lunar resources extraction efforts. Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.